bread, honey.
I know, it
this
looks
is
good.
Lovely.
Oh, we're getting
Did
lunch
Ted
too?
Make this?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, cheers, queers.
Cheers, cheers girls.
Cheers. Cheers.
So I honestly was inspired most by Tom. You know, I literally got fired from my job because of Queer Eye. Remember when you filmed the Restoration Hardware?
Yes.
So the night before, I managed that Restoration Hardware. And I was in charge of getting the store perfect for you guys to film the next day. And the general manager, because I forgot to clock out, we were there so late, had clocked us all out at 8 p.m. I was like, oh, well, that's not right. We were there till 1. So I fixed our time, and that was totally against the rules. And while you were upstairs filming, I was getting fired.
Really?
Oh,
really?
And now look at you.
And I just have to say, look at me now.
I think the one thing we wanted to talk about was why we think like Queer Eye is still culturally relevant. And I think that we're lucky enough, having done the original show, we see the original impact. And I think Kyan was telling the story, I was telling the story how like we're on a plane and a young flight attendant will give us a napkin that says, I watched your show with my family and it allowed me to come out to them and have a conversation and it made me feel safe. And that's wonderful. And literally every time you get goosebumps.
Well, what you're experiencing on television, I experienced that in this little town because I was very out from a very young age. And we do need to be there showing those people that don't have exposure in the bubbles of the coast that there is a safe place and it will get better.
We didn't know, we honestly, while we were shooting it, we had no idea that it would be successful, that it would have any kind of cultural impact.
Right,
even when they told us it did, I don't think it
And really, I think that's why, I think that's why it was successful, because we weren't out there with a megaphone saying, hey, we're here, we're queer,
you were actually,
look at us,
we're
we were just, maybe I was.
When I watched you guys and do what you do, it was incredible, absolutely incredible. And you did help so many young kids, but there's still so much more work to do. The fact that we are now in a position where there's a black guy on this show, on a commercial show, who is gay and he's got children.
What?
Yeah. I know. Listen, I know. There's a Muslim man on this show who's openly gay.
And married to a Mormon.
And married to a Mormon.
That is hilarious. I love that.
When we were growing up, we really didn't have anyone on television to look up to and say, these are queer people and I can relate to that. And
no precedent.
I think that, you know, for the generation of kids that grew up watching Queer Eye, that was the first time that they could look to a television set in their home and see, you know, five gay guys that were just being themselves.
You don't have to be best friends, but you will forever be brothers.
Yeah. Right.
And this experience is so much greater than just our individual categories. And it is an opportunity to share who we are and our gifts and our talents with the world. But more importantly, I think it's a bigger opportunity for those kids who are looking up to us, or maybe someone who's never met a gay person, but just is obsessed with the way you style a room. Mm-hmm. And now that is the thing that bridges them.
Our goal is the same, and that's what connects.
I just want to say you guys can definitely call on us.
Yes, please.
Everyone.
Snapchat us, Instagram
us. DM
us. Just send a simple note.
Yes. Raise your glasses. I just want to say cheers to the path you all created, and for us new five, walking in our own shoes.
Cheers.
Cheers, queers.
Cheers.